All right, guys. Hello and welcome to Let's Play Elden Ring, part 51. Pointing to do stuff. Yeah. I suppose I should actually try out some different weapons. Yeah, we have a claymore. If I could pair that. What are the strength requirements? 16 and. Just for fun. I think we can actually test this configuration. Yeah, over here. So you get here and you can. Oh, sweet, you can two-hand. So this could be viable as a heavier for doing heavier poise damage, because we meet the requirements to two-hand both of those. For the immediate future, I want to I think build up a straight sword alternative. And we also would like to. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff we want to do. It's just a matter of what makes sense. Oh, you're still here?
Hello. You've been busy weeding Deathroot, I take it. I thank you, as your brother in arms. So, what can I do for you?
I guess we can give you the weathered dagger.
How did you get your hands on that dagger? Well, that hardly matters. I know very well whose dagger it is. Why don't I return it to them for you? Good work bringing this to me.
Okay, yeah. Sure. Oh, we actually need more runes. A lot more. All right. Well, I can ascend pretty much anything I want up to that level now. We'll go to the Black Knife Catacombs. We'll clear this off our list. It's actually apparently storyline for Rajir. I forgot to replace the secondary weapon as well. Okay, we've got two keen scimitars now. I think I shirked away from this because we were fighting undead. Grave Glowworm 2. these guys are not dying. Wondering if this guy's the reason why. Yeah, it seems to be. Stone sword key was lost. So we just need to Rosas's axe. It's a physical and magic scaling axe. Interesting. This one's also being controlled by someone. So we have to find the Unless he's still connected to that first one? Looks like they're still reconstituted. Spellproof dried liver. Alright, we'll just keep running then. Ow. Summoner for that. I assume at some point we run into. Gray Violet. Gray Blowwort. There's another one over here. Oh my God. Too confident. Just far too confident. So I came down from there. Stuck on this side? That can't be right. We're missing something, obviously. Oh, interesting. And that just killed all of them. This guy again. And they just insta die. Where did they're sometimes dropping things. I have a beacon somewhere, but I don't know why it's been. He's dead. Let's just play this very. So we can drop from here. There's a lever ahead. I can't verify that there's a lever ahead. Oh, boss room. That's the boss room. That lets us into this room. Very cool. Oh, there's two. Two for one. Neat. All right. It's like, what's going on here? So, so if we double back, wait, we can't. So at the beginning of the area, where the site of grace is actually, yeah, and then there's a boss room down here. So let's do the hidden one first. Since the run back to this one is going to be significantly easier. I'm just looking for any other hidden things too. Is there a steak of Marika up here? I sure hope so. Oh. Overconfidence. Black knife print. Back to the entrance, and then there's a second boss door. That one had to be done one-on-one, though. It looks like we are fighting more death. Okay. Yeah. We want to actually rest and get our flasks back. Makes sense. Now I can go. So if we follow this down, where did we put... Did we accidentally mark the round table? Yeah, that's exactly... At least it seems like what happened. Whatever, we'll figure it out. Okay. Got a jellyfish plus 3. I'm dying to use it. Thank you. killed them. Wow. Okay. That was easy. Maybe easy isn't the right way to put it, but... Death Root. Back to the entrance. We will retreat. To the Lost Site of Grace. Found it. Now this room is actually empty. Go figure. And we're not doing this specifically to level now. I want to buy specifically. Let's get like 12 of these. Then like I need like more of everything basically.
I asked you not to be thankful, it is all the key.
Okay. So we need more runes, basically, to upgrade our weapons more. Let's go to Rajir.
Always good to see you safe. So, what do you need?
This is a black knife print. I can scarcely believe you managed to get your hands on this.
You recall our conversation about the Knight of the Black Knives, yes? They say the assassins who carried out the deed were scions of the Eternal City. A group entirely of women, arrayed in armor of silver under cloaks which fooled the eye. The knives they wielded, though, were imparted with the power of the Rune of Death through sinister rite. Please, I beg of you, lend me the knife print for a time. I'd love nothing more than to tease out its secrets. Though only a fragment, a very specific ritual had to be performed to impart the power of the Rune of Death. Traces of the one who performed the rite are sure to remain in the imprint. Half my body has been suffused with death. I'm certain it will help me see.
So we travel back in. And we go back up here.
Ah, hello. I was hoping to see you. My examination is complete. Here's the knife print back, with my thanks. Now I have a fairly good idea who performed the rite upon the blade. The person who orchestrated the Knight of the Black Knives, Luna Princess Rani, one of the children born to King Consort Radagon and his first wife, Ranala, demigod and sister to General Radahn and Praetor Rykard. Hers was the name I discovered in the imprint. Truly, you have my thanks. But if I might be so bold, I would like to ask something more of you. If Rani truly is the one who plotted that fateful night, then she should bear the curse mark of destined death somewhere upon her flesh. I would like you to procure it for me. And then all will be laid bare. I will have the answers I've sought for so long. I have some idea of Rani's potential whereabouts. There's a manor to the north of the Academy of Rhea Lucaria. It is the familial home of the Carian royals from whom Rani descends. There's been talk of the old royals' vassals gathering there in recent years. Rani's whereabouts since the shattering are a well-kept secret. She hasn't been seen even once. But I suspect she might have returned to the manor in which she was born. I'm afraid there's something I must tell you. Do you know of those who live in death? The very notion of life in death defies the Golden Order. By Dee's account, these defiled fiends must be expunged. But truth be told, I seek the curse mark to save them. You may find this peculiar, but I discovered something in my examination of the Knight of the Black Knives. These souls have committed no offense. They have every right to life. Only they happen to touch upon a flaw in the order. Yes, indeed. If Dee knew what drives me now, he would surely boil over with rage. Or perhaps he would even feel some pity. But no need to fret. None of that will come to pass. I can tell a good lie when I need to.
There. Alright, I'm just kind of messing around with my headset here for a moment. Okay. I wanted to make sure it was still muted like it should be. Alright, we should actually have found what he has us searching for. I've cleared this, and I believe I've cleared that too. Let's go check quick. Pretty sure I cleared it. So we can actually remove that marker too. See if I bring the entire map up, if I can see where I'm at. We have to I'm looking up this Three Sisters area. We basically have to clear a certain part of the game. See if it points out where it is to us. Yeah, the only way through is to actually beat that keep, based on where I see it on the map. So we cannot do Rajir's quest at the moment, at this exact moment. We're just kind of stuck. Sorry. Maybe I can get summoned. We'll see. Give me access to a few more rune arts, maybe. I think we actually have gotten beyond being summoned for this area to an extent. So we will actually trying to remember. Specifically, how we clear this area. Whoops. Yeah, we're gonna finish this off because there's no real sense in continuing this, I think. So we'll just okay. It's entirely possible I've missed stuff too. In this specific area, but I don't. I think I've pretty much found everything I'm going to find. Ooh, jump over. This breaks off. You just kind of have to trust it to actually do that. Entirely sure how you get onto the other side of that. Oh, well. Are you serious? Okay, we just kind of used our brain on this one. It's another shortcut. Climb? So much for the plan. .tm. Sanctuary stone. So this is new. Rather that I. Okay, they're the ones making this. Glenstone Scarab. Scarab. Visions of item, but try down. Yeah, we're actually finding more stuff. Go figure. Oh, it's a good item. Okay. Seek turn back. So. I'm just curious. I think we do get a direct feed in somewhere here. That's just makes little sense to me, but we shouldn't have any trouble with this boss now. Skeletal militiaman? Or rather the bandit. So they should switch places now and I can just pop this guy.
Yeah.
find the book. We have to basically repeat the process. Killing the book door is the only thing that actually weakens her. So we have to find the book thrower yet again. There's the book thrower. Back to the main room. Oh. Oh, we have another one. This is probably one of the weirdest boss battles I've ever had to fight in.
My beloved, have no fear. I will hold thee. Born forever and ever. Upon my name is Rani the Witch. Mother's rich slumber shall not be disturbed by thee. Send word far and wide. Of the last queen of Caria, Renala of the Full Moon. And the majesty of the night she conjureth.
This time you're going down. Oh. You have to be very careful of this. Oh, we almost died. That was nuts. All right.
Where did he flee, my sweetings? Come out from whence ye hide. There are books and light aplenty, dither not. Come out, say I, or will ye be gravestones to be better born anew? Ah, thou, is it thy wish to be born anew? To become a sweeting, reborn of my beloved egg?
What is this rebirth stuff? Huh. So this is basically a respec. A larval tear.
Not alarmed, nor afeared.
So now she helps us. That's so weird.
As a sweeting, fair and fine.
Larval tear. I don't know if we actually have one. Now we have her great soul to, yeah. Interesting. Let's open this chest. It's locked. Okay, it looks like, I'm not sure exactly what to do, how to go about like really any of this at this point, but yeah, we can just straight up come back here at any time. It looks like by killing her, we've earned the right to respec. Although we didn't really kill her, we just, looks like we just defeated her. Sorry, like, I get into this, and I'm just like, what's the lore behind all this, basically? Like, why is she not gone? Alright, so...